Would you like to learn about multi-cloud architecture? Would you like to learn why multi-cloud architecture is the future and why 98% of businesses use more than one cloud? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Mike Gibbs. I'm the founder and CEO of Go Cloud Careers. And I've been training multi-cloud architects for as long as I can remember. And I've got clients that I've worked with who work at Amazon and Cisco and IBM and Microsoft and Google, Accenture, Deloitte, KPMG, Capgemini, PricewaterhouseCoopers, and many other prestigious organizations. And one of the reasons those organizations love them is they know multi-cloud. So let's talk about why cloud architects need to know multi-cloud and hybrid cloud architectures. Well, first, 98% of companies use more than one cloud. So if you only know a single cloud, most companies can't hire you. That should be a good enough reason to learn multi-cloud. In addition, being able to work with multi-clouds makes you more valuable and increases your salary. But let's also talk about why multi-cloud is so critical. And if you're an architect, why knowing multi-cloud is essential for you to be good at your job. Let's talk about the reasons organizations use multi-cloud architectures. The first one is actually availability. From a perspective of availability or the systems being there when you need them, nothing beats multi-cloud. Most people wouldn't put all of their retirement income in a single stock or put all their eggs in a single basket. And when you put all your systems in a single cloud provider, that's effectively what you're doing. So if you're on a single cloud and it fails, big things can happen. And it's not that the cloud providers aren't good at running their systems. They're great at it, but all technology fails. AWS has plenty of failures. Google has their failures, and Microsoft has plenty of failures. All technology fails. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And what you need to be able to do is keep that business up and operational when the technology fails. And to be fair, there is no amount of availability zones, which means data centers or regions in a single cloud, that will improve availability, because here's the reason. All it takes is a single network failure because maybe somebody made a routing error, a security incident, or a control plane failure, the part that orchestrates the cloud, and the whole cloud is gone and it doesn't matter where you are in the world on that single cloud. But with a multi-cloud architecture, when one of your cloud providers fails, guess what? The other one most likely won't be at the same time, and you'll still be up and operational. Let's talk about cost. If we work with hybrid multi-clouds, we can often get the cost to be cheaper, and I'll talk about why. Systems that run all the time at high performance are typically much cheaper in the data center, often several 100% cheaper. By comparison, systems that have light or sporadic use, like an event-driven architecture, are often cheaper in the cloud, the public cloud especially. Or we may have a website, for example, of a global retailer. And that might also be cheaper in the public cloud, and here's the reason why. Most websites for retailers run at very low utilization most of the time, and they are overbuilt to handle, say, spikes around holidays and holiday sales. With cloud computing, we can put the systems all on a small set of systems that meet average use, and we can use some form of auto-scaling in the big holiday seasons or whenever the big sales occur. So we can optimize cost by putting the right technology in the right place. The next is related to features and expertise. Each cloud provider has various strengths and weaknesses. For example, Microsoft has extreme investments in AI. And a lot of AI expertise and digital transformation expertise. Oracle has an incredible amount of expertise with healthcare and a tremendous number of medical professionals that even work for them because they acquired Cerner, a major clinical application. Google has tremendous amount of big data expertise because big data and search has effectively been Google's business for decades. So you can see working with three different providers could give you three benefits of different organizations. The next piece is performance. Look, I love cloud computing, but when we set up the data center or a private cloud, we get the best performance in most cases, and I'll tell you why. I can put a 19 million IOPS RAID card in a server in my data center. Try doing that in the cloud with block storage. sure, I could have arrayed via maybe 50 or 75 virtual drives and then another 75 or so in RAID 10, but you know that's going to be way more costly than doing in the data center, and even still, the performance will be less. In the data center or the private cloud, often where our people are in the same campus, we don't have any latency going to the cloud like we do in a cloud environment because we've got a wide area network. We can optimize the network in the private cloud to prioritize certain types of traffic, what have you, but we can't do that on the public cloud. So performance of local systems is typically going to be better in the data center. Performance of other things are perfectly fine in the cloud, things that are not, say, latency sensitive. So performance might be another reason organizations would use hybrid multi-cloud. Disaster recovery. Multi-cloud is perfect for disaster recovery. Disaster recovery is what happens to a business when a catastrophic event occurs. For example, maybe there would be a huge hacking event, or maybe there would be an electromagnetic pulse, or maybe there would be an earthquake or a flood or something that could take down a large area. Now, many people and organizations have tried to put disaster recovery in the same cloud, albeit in a different region. But if you think about that, that's kind of ridiculous. Because if you're putting your backup systems inside of your same organization, if they have a major disaster, you're done. So instead, if you've got your systems in, say, one cloud, your disaster recovery and your systems and backup could be in a different cloud. And then we don't have that problem. And another reason organizations use multi-cloud. Another reason organizations use multi-cloud is to avoid vendor lock-in. Now, to be fair, vendor lock-in is more about using an organization's proprietary services than it actually is over the provider themselves. But when you're multi-cloud, if you do multi-cloud right, you're forced to use non-proprietary systems, which often are far better systems anyway, and that gives you a system that's more agile to adopt to new technologies on whatever platform you want in the future. So we don't have those single vendor issues. So how do you learn multi-cloud? It's easy. So imagine you learned how to drive a Honda, and Hyundais are great cars. I've had one for many years. I don't have one now, but I had one for many years in my youth, and I loved it. Now, what would have happened years later when I bought a Volvo or a Mercedes if I was only trained to drive a Honda? What was I going to do, go back to driving school again and learn how to drive a different vehicle? No, I learned how to drive a car. So when you learn multi-cloud, learn the actual technology. You'll have no problem. If you know what a virtual machine is, whether you work in a VMware cloud or a Nutanix cloud, an OpenStack cloud, it's all the same. Now, granted, AWS might call their virtual machine an EC2 instance. Google might call their virtual machine a compute engine instance. Azure may call it an Azure VM. VMware calls it a VMware VM. And Oracle calls it a virtual machine. But it's the same technology. Look, we could look at object storage the same way. We could call it object storage and learn object storage. Or we could call it AWS S3 or Microsoft Blob or Google Cloud Stores. But it's the same thing. It's the same object storage we've been using for decades. So keep that in the back of your mind. Remember, most cloud services, like 90% of them, are just virtual versions of things that are, say, in the data center, like a virtual machine or a container or a database, what have you. It's the same technology that's been used in the data center for years. So learn these skills. Learn network design skills. Guess what? They're the same in every cloud. They're related to wide area network planning and IP address planning and routing, for example, and routing protocols such as BGP and, say, load balancers. It's the same compute design skills no matter where you're at, whether it be, you know, virtual machines or container orchestration or function and containers, functions as a service. It's all the same in all clouds. Same storage area networks, the same block storage, object storage, file storage, and RAID in all cloud providers. It's the same security design skills. So learn how to design your demilitarized zone, your security policies, your data loss prevention, those types of things. And typically speaking, when you go multi-cloud, you've got to go to the big industry vendors. So that means going to a Palo Alto or a Fortinet or a Checkpoint or a Cisco for your firewall, as opposed to the cloud native firewall. And in generally speaking, you get greater features and functionality from the next generation firewalls that'll work in all your clouds anyway. Now, you will need to have some good big data design skills, meaning, you know, planning your databases and planning how to, say, data lakes, for example, and data pipelines. And of course, you'll need to know some AI to system design. And for the most part, it doesn't matter which cloud you're on, it's fairly similar design if you use standards-based approaches to designing your systems. Now, here's the secret to making hybrid clouds and hybrid multi-clouds work. Don't use proprietary services. So half of what's taught in a certification is just not usable because they lock you into a single cloud. So for example, Amazon has this very simple, easy to use, and quite pleasant Elastic Container Service. But what are you going to do if you've got containers in Google and Microsoft at the same time? You can't use those. But you could set up Kubernetes, and not a managed Kubernetes product by the cloud provider, but say something like IBM OpenShift or manage your own Kubernetes clusters and have it across all three clouds. It's going to work smoothly. Don't use a cloud provider's proprietary database. So instead of using, say, an Amazon DynamoDB or an Azure Cosmos, use a MongoDB or an Apache Cassandra. It's going to work everywhere. Don't use a cloud provider's proprietary firewall services like an AWS WAF. Replace it with a more robust next-generation firewall like those from Palo Alto or Cisco or Fortinet or Checkpoint. Think about maybe nixing Kinesis and replacing with Apache Kafka. You get the point. We're using the bigger services that will work in a standards-based environment across all clouds, as opposed to the cloud provider's tools, their proprietary tools. And it's better for your client long-term anyway, because as market conditions change, or maybe a cloud provider raises their price, and they want to leverage more of another provider service, if we're using standards-based approaches, we have no problem making this occur. So now you know why 98% of cloud architectures are multi-cloud. And you also now know why multi-cloud, or the ability to design a multi-cloud architecture, is going to be a critical success factor in your cloud architect career. If you'd like to become a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or an AI architect or a security architect, join us for a free webinar. The link for these free webinars is in the description of this video. We also have a tremendous amount of free resources in the description of this video to help you in your career. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.